for your patience. There are no items requiring a vote following our executive session. Item 3, receive information, take desired action on various boards and committees. First is behavioral health. Next, we have Board of Appeals, Assessment Appeals. We need to fill those two positions. Building Code Board of Appeals, we need to fill that position. And then Community Development Advisory. Next, we have Cooley Springs Fingerville Fire Service.
Mr. Chairman, I move that we waive the rules and nominate Mr. Jason Merchant.
Second.
We have a motion and a second on Jason Merchant. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, vote affirmative, and it passes. We need to fill Domestic Violence Board. And then we get to Employee Grievance Committee. We have a nominee.
Chairman, I'd like to waive rules and nominate John Woodsby.
Have a motion on John. Do we have a second?
Second.
Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. Opposed, vote affirmative, and it passes. We need to fill Hobbiesville Fire District. We have a spot. And then we get to the Library Board of Trustees.
Mr. Chairman, I'd like to waive rules and nominate Rodney Good and John Cribb.
Second.
We have a motion and a second on Rodney Good and John Cribb. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, vote affirmative, and it passes.
Mr. Chairman.
Yes, sir.
I'd like to waive rules and ask the unanimous request to nominate Randy Foster and Mark Thompson.
Second.
We have a motion and a second on Randy Foster and Mark Thompson. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. Opposed, vote affirmative, and it passes.
I'd like to waive rules and nominate elect Mr. Brian Morris.
Second.
We have a motion on Byron Morris and a second. Any other discussion? All in favor, raise your right hand. All opposed, vote affirmative, and it passes. We need to fill a spot on the ULMO Board of Appeals, and we have to fill a spot on the Water and Sewer Advisory Committee. So let's try to get those wrapped up next month as well. That concludes that part of this agenda. We will now go to our committee reports. The first is Economic Recruitment and Development. Honorable David Britt, Chairman. Michael Brown, Roger Nutt, members. Mr. Britt.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. First item before the committee, we have a request to render first reading to an ordinance authorizing the execution and delivery of an amended and restated fee agreement by and among Spartanburg County, South Carolina, Apollo 17 LLC, and Ritterama Inc. with respect to certain economic development property in the county. Do your motion for the approval first reading?
So moved.
Second.
And second, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Motion carries. We'll recommend that to full council. Well, this particular project was interesting. Even before they finished completing the building, they're already expanding, which is a great sign for this company and Spartanburg County. The next item, we have a request to render first reading to an ordinance authorizing the execution and delivery of an agreement as to assignment and assumption of lease agreement by and between Spartanburg County, South Carolina, and AFL Telecommunications LLC, and B, the First Amendment to lease agreement by and between the county and the company, both in connection with certain existing property located in the county and other matters related thereto. Do I hear a motion that we render?
So moved.
First reading. Motion is made and second. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Motion carries. The next item, we have a request to adopt a resolution authorizing under certain conditions the execution and delivery by Spartanburg County, South Carolina of a special source revenue credit agreement with Project Tulip with respect to an industrial project in the county, whereby the project would be subject to non-negotiated payments of certain fee in lieu of taxes, and whereby Project Tulip will be provided certain credits against fee payments and reimbursement of investment and related qualified property. Do you hear a motion to adopt a resolution? Motion been made.
Second.
And seconded. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Motion carries. We'll recommend that full council at 5:30. Next item, we have a request to render first reading to an ordinance authorizing the execution and delivery of a special source revenue credit agreement by and between Spartanburg County, South Carolina, Project Tulip with respect to certain fee in lieu of tax payments related to certain investments in the county. Do I hear a motion? We approve first reading of this ordinance.
So moved.
Second. Motion been made and second. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Motion carries. Likewise, we'll recommend to full council at 5:30. And the last item, we have a request to adopt a resolution approving under certain conditions the addition of a company known to the county as Project Pollux as a sponsor affiliate to that fee in lieu tax agreement between Spartanburg County and Liberty Property Limited Partnerships, authorizing the negotiation and delivery of credits against fee payments and reimbursement of investment by a company known to the county as Project Pollux. Do I hear a motion that we adopt this resolution?
So moved.
Second.
Motion been made and second. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Motion carries. We'll recommend that to the council at 5:30. Mr. Chairman, that concludes our committee meeting.
Thank you, Mr. Brett.
Sir.
No items under public health. We do have a couple under personnel and finance. Honorable Bob Walker, Chairman, Jeff Horton, Justin Bradley, members. Mr. Walker.
Thank you, Chairman. We want to receive information and take desired action in relation to a resolution ordered a bond referendum be held in the Fall Fire District on the question of the issuance of not exceeding $2 million.